Don't be shy.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
I try to wake up every day at 5:30.
Yes.
Even if I'm not in the Zen Center, to exercise and if possible to do a little bit of sitting. So then I realized that I actually have more time. I'm always ahead of people when I go to office. But the challenge is, could be the family, could be the my social circle, they tend to stay up late. So it caused me to sleep late, but to wake up early. So in the end, I sleep deficit. So what should I do?
So what's most important for you?
Don't know.
Okay, keep that mind. So more sleep deprivation necessary. But you can ask yourself, if you are smart, I think you are, what is most important for me? Just sit down and assess. Yeah, of course inside you know practice is important, right? Because like you said, you do it, then you're ahead of everybody and more prepared, you know? Like, you understand that you're functioning much better. And of course, family is important, parents are important, also friends, very important, social life, important. But what is most important for you? I'm not saying don't spend time with your family. I'm not saying. But you can also look at how do you keep this practicing mind during the day? At work, if you don't have to think or talk, maybe you can have 5 minutes break and breathe in slowly and slowly breathe out and ask, what is this? Or whatever is your practice. Maybe after lunch break, you can walk back to your office. And of course, it's nice to walk back with your colleagues and chat, chat, chat and gossip or whatever. But maybe you can go around the block one more time and do your practice and do 10 minutes of walking meditation. Every day, actually, you know, especially here, all of us, except for the two Sunnis, we are lay people. And our biggest, baddest excuse is, I have no time. I'm too busy. Everybody very busy? You have busy life? Who here has busy life? Please raise your hand. Come on. Actually, it's not time you have a problem with. You have a problem of clarity. Because you have time. If you really paid attention ourselves to each of our day, we have time to practice. We can practice the moment you get in the elevator, and when you get off the elevator, you can do about 20 kvasimbos. Even here. Here you can do 50, it's very slow. Then you take elevator home, and as soon as you get out of the elevator, go into home, and you see your mother, you say, Mom, how are you? Then you do 100% just do it meditation. Mother-son meditation. She make you delicious food, you eat, say, thank you, Mom, I love you. And that's kvasimbos of mind already. Make her happy. Then you're already doing your Kwansan Bosa undercover Bodhisattva 007 job. Then you take your dishes, go to the kitchen, wash them, and inside Kwansan Bosa, Kwansan Bosa, then Kwansan Bosa washing dishes. Then you, first of all, helping your mother do dishes, and then you help yourself and all beings by looking inside. Only Kwansan Bosa. Who is repeating, who is washing dishes right now? Only just do it. Yeah. Outside, nobody hear you. But inside, Kwansan Bosa. Kwansan Bosa bank growing. Very rich. And more you give away, more rich. Then, you already did your practice. situation with mama, okay, family, correct relationship with her, your house, your situation, and then correct function as a loving son. Okay? So that's then clear mind, compassion, and correct action, bodhisattva action. How can I help in this moment, moment to moment to moment to moment, all different situation relationships? Then your practice and your everyday life situation is always going together like this. Does that answer your question?
Yes, thank you so much.
Any other questions?